I will surely come a second time, one day more.
One day, not live until today. How can I live when we are parted?
One day more.
Tomorrow you'll be miles away. And yet with you my world has started.
Tomorrow we'll discover what's up.
Summer? Who cares that summer is here? As far as I know, they could pave over every forest, fill every valley, and drain every pond. Or they could put like a bubble over towns and parks and stuff, so you could make every day the desired temperature and remain cool and comfy all year long. The best thing that they came up with was climate control. Last summer, my parents thought it'd be a good idea to go on a trip to get back to nature. They went to the cabin in the middle of the woods. It had three rooms. That's it. A living area, a big bedroom, with no bed, might I add, and a bathroom. Thank God it had a working toilet, or I would have hitchhiked down there that instant. We ate cold food, we slept on the floor, and we suffered enough family bonding to last a lifetime. My parents are hinting at another summer lovers vacation again this year. Something about driving out west to see the Grand Canyon before it's gone. It's several million years old. Where's it going? Anyway, I said that I would only go if there was a hot hotel room with a hot shower and a soft bed with room service at the touch of a button. Who needs summer? Nature's for the freaking birds. Maybe I'll just go to summer school instead.
Can't you smell it? It smells like summer. Doesn't the salt in the air make you feel alive? I don't know how all these indoor types of people can do it. I mean, who could possibly stay inside on a day like today? I've always been an outdoorsy type of person, but it's mostly my parents' fault. You see, Mom says that anytime it was time to go inside when I was little, I would throw a temper tantrum, no matter what season it was. Arms flailing, knees kicking, screaming, the works. But, I mean, who could really blame me? What to what could possibly compare to a beach full of miles of sand, endless waves to ride, and people to watch? On a hot day, I like to bury myself deep in the sand. And at first it feels cool, like the beaches give me a hug. And then, after I've baked long and good in the sun, I like to tumble out and run for the water. Ah, one splash and I'm calm and clean all over again. The beach is undoubtedly my favorite place to be, but it doesn't really matter as long as I'm outside. I love the bigness of the mountains. They make me feel so small. I love the size of an open prairie. The sky looks as if it could just swallow me up, and I'm afraid to speak because my voice would not even begin to fill the vast space. You know, my parents encouraged me too. We've gone camping every Memorial Day since I can remember. When I turned 13, Dad and I started hiking the Appalachian Trail in honor of starting my teenage years. Our plan is to hike all 2,167 miles of it before I turn 20. It's not as easy as what all these people might think it is. You really have to move. You can't just wander from place to place. But at night, when we'd sit and rest, the sun would sink down and peek between the trees as if to say goodnight. And then we'd start a small fire to cook our food. And we'd just sit and listen as the noises started. It's not as scary as what all these indoor people think it is. It's actually quite amazing. Anyway, our annual trip isn't until the end of summer. So right now, I'm going to dig a deep hole, bury myself deep in the sand, and watch the surf roll in. Gosh, I love summertime. Care to join me?
Welcome one and all to our 2018 Curtain Call program.
What even is a curtain call anyway? Hey, Curtain, what's up? How's it hanging, man?
No, Blake. Outdoorsy people are so uncultured. Curtain call is like at the end of a performance when all the performers come out and bow.
Oh, so this show is going to be a bunch of people bowing the whole time.
No, it's like at the end of a season performance, whenever all the performers perform one last encore, if you will.
Okay.
For example, we just got to watch the musical theater. We'll also get to hear from AP Band Theory Class, Percussion Ensemble, Chamber Choir, Chamber Orchestra, and Drama during this first act.
Oh, I get it now. But I think you're forgetting the most important part.
What's that?
The whole night is themed Sweet Summertime.
I hardly call that the most important part, but you're right, that's the theme.
I love summer.
We know.
And the great outdoors.
We know.
And the feel of the
We summer. Know! You literally just gave an entire monologue about how much you love nature and summer and bugs and all that. Let's just start the show.
Oh, okay. Alright. Hey, Kurt, call me sometime.
Thank you. Thank you.
Called The Young Man's Dream, which was transcribed by Edward Bunting in 1792. Our performance today has been arranged as a part of the final project by the AP Music Theory class.
Will do next. Each year they learn different aspects within the realm of musical theater and accumulate into their final project. They are assigned a jury piece and are to learn, block, choreograph, and direct it on their own.
This is one of the jury pieces chosen for this year. Rebecca Brown unfortunately had to battle faulty technology at their concert, So we're going to give her another opportunity to shine with When He Sees Me from the musical Waitress.
Masterminded some way to find me.